fastest to that point in the jump off. You're right, Chad. Well, you saw our speediest round, but with a last bench down. How about a great effort for Credence and Kent Farrington for the United States with four faults leading the way right now, 35-19 with four.
Well, McLean Moore took the title for the fourth time, but he almost lost it tonight because Kent Farrington flew down that final line, picked up a faster time. Just reflecting on the round tonight, Kent, you came down to the last and it did come down. If you could go back and do it again, would you do anything differently down to that last line?
I had a bad stumble, 1-2, and that kind of put me a little bit behind at the beginning, so I felt like I had to make up some time, and I actually felt like he was losing his ground a little bit on a couple of the rollbacks. And I think on a sensitive horse like that, he's still very green, leaving out a stride and then still slowing down at the end. But it's coming. He's improved a lot already, and I think he's going to keep getting better as he goes more indoors.
And what's the horse's history? How long have you had him?
I got him when he was 7 years old. He's just 9 now. He's already had some big results in Grand Prix, and my goal was to get him going strong on the indoor tour and see if maybe he'd be ready for a World Cup final. That's still a long way away, and that's a big ask, so we'll see if he's ready by then.
But you're going to be in Omaha with something.
I'd like to be, but it's still a long ways out, so we'll see.
Well, many congratulations, finishing second here tonight, of course, and hopefully we'll see Kent Farrington in Omaha when we join the Longines FEI World Cup final there early next year.